Hey there. So today we are creating another hover effect, and this hover effect is called pinch zoom. And just like my previous setup, you will find HTML on the left, my SASS code on the center, and compiled CSS will be on the right. So if you don't know how to use SASS, always view it on the right. What's happening? So let's start with the HTML. So first I'm going to create a wrap. Then inside we need a container, and then I want a heading, and it will be having text called pinch zoom. And then we'll be having our list, and this list will have a class called pinch zoom list, and inside this we'll be having four list item. Let's add some text. This is our HTML. We have a wrap, we have a container, then we have a heading, and then we have our list. So let's start the styling. So I have already defined my container as having width 80%, max width 1200 pixels, and margin auto, so that it will always be in center. And then I have given some basic padding. So let's start styling our wrap. And our wrap, I want it to have a width of 100%, and its height will be 100% as well. So we'll be giving it 100 BH, and then we'll be giving it a background called red VG. And this red VG I've already defined as this color. So you can see the background here. So let's see how it's looking in the browser. So now you can see we have a red background, and now we can't see our text. So let's add some color, and I'll be making this as white. So let's see. Now we can see our text, but I want my headings and list to be in center of the page. For that, we'll be using display flex and justify content center and align item center as well, so that our items will be in center. So that's for the wrap. Now we'll be styling our heading, and we'll be increasing its font size to 48 pixels. And its font weight to bold, and giving it a text transform of uppercase, and then we'll be giving it a text align of center. So let's see how it's looking in our browsers. So now we have a bold text in center. Also, let's add some padding to this. Let's say 40 pixels padding. So now we have some padding as well. So now let's start styling our list items. So that will be pinch zoom list. And I'll be giving it some padding, let's say 20 pixels. And we want our list items to be in center, and space should be equally distributed around them. For that, we'll be using display flex and justify content as space around. So now you can see we have our allies in center with some space between them. So let's start styling our allies. I'll be adding some padding. 15 pixel should be fine. And then we'll be increasing its font size to 24 pixels and font weight to bold. And let's see how it's looking in browsers. So now we have a bold list. Now we want our effect to have two borders which are coming from top left and bottom right corners, and they'll be zooming out. So and then they'll be doing a pinch zoom effect. For that, we'll be using before and after element. So let's start them styling them, and we'll be giving them an empty content and their display will be block. And their width and height will be 0 by default, and they'll be position absolute, and our li will be position relative. Okay, now on a hover, on li hover, we want our before to be on negative left 15 pixels and top of negative left 15 pixels. Also, we want it to have width 100% and height 100%, and then it should have a border left of 5 pixels with dotted borders and white color. Same thing we want for border top. Similarly, we'll be doing our after element. And this time we want our after element to be bottom negative 15 pixels and top negative 15 pixels, and its width should be 100% and height should be 100%, and its border right should be 5 pixels solid white. Same thing for its border bottom. So let's see how it's looking in our browser. Let's add a cursor pointer to our li. The border should be dotted and this should be our right. So now you can see our final state is here. So when we hover, we see dotted borders. But our effect is not like this. We want first our borders to grow and then we want them to expand out. So to do that, we'll be using keyframes. And I'll be defining my keyframe. We'll be needing two keyframes, one for our top left border and other for our bottom right border. So for that, I'll be defining two keyframes. First will be pinch left, and we'll be having three steps here: 0%, 50%, and 100%. Similarly, we'll be having a right pinch right, so for left our initial position will be 0 and our top will be 0. So this is for our top left borders, and our 50% position will be width 100% and its height should be 100%, and our 100% position will be left negative 15 pixels and right negative 15 pixels. Similarly, our bottom right keyframe will have bottom 0, right 0, and our 50% position will be width 100% and height 100%. And our 100% will be bottom negative 15 pixels and right negative 15 pixels. Also, we don't want our borders to show up before hover, so we'll be giving them opacity of 0 initially and adding a transition all 0.4 seconds, and we'll be giving it a ease in out curve. So now let's add our pinch left and pinch right. So pinch left will be going to before and pinch right will be going to after. So let's add animation pinch left, and let it give 1 second, and we want it to have an ease in out curve. Same thing in after, we'll be having pinch right. So let's see. Also, we have to add opacity 1 to before and after so that they are visible after hover, because we added opacity 0 here. So this is the effect which I wanted to share with you today. If you like the video, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. If you have any doubt, leave them in comment box below. The source code for the project is in the description. Make sure you check that out. And I'll see you next time.